So hello and welcome to the next of these short AZtecCrystal training videos. This one we're going to focus on the whole process of loading up data, cleaning the data, and what happens when we close it and open it again, and how we can restore projects back to the original data. So when you open AZtec as a standalone program using the icon on the desktop or directly from the start menu, as opposed to when you launch it from within AZtec, what you see is this opening screen. And this shows recent files that have been opened using the Windows login on that particular computer. And then there's a second tab which shows the demo data sets. There's five demo data sets, and these data sets have been used extensively in some of the other training material we've supplied for the system and in the AZtecCrystal help system. If you put the cursor over one of these projects, you can actually see a little bit of information when it was created, the size, some of the phases, for example. And to open up one of these projects, you simply click on it. Of course, you can also open up projects directly from file. It will show you by default the projects that have the new HDF5 file extension. But if you want to open up older data in the Channel 5 project form, so the star.cpr form, or as channel text files, or even as an edex.ang file, we can do that. So I'm going to open up one of these duplex stainless steel data sets. And when you open a data set in AZtecCrystal, it will automatically, for the first time, create a phase map, an orientation map using the inverse pole figure parallel to the sample normal. And it will calculate the grain size information, and it will also calculate a basic pole figure for the first phase in the list. What we're going to do here is look at data cleaning. And on the left-hand side with the project details, you can see the project listed up in the data tree. And down below that, we see a little panel which has basic information about the project, the name, the size, the step size, and so on. And it also will show us the hit rate, in this case, 98.76%. And it will say whether this project has been modified or if this is the original data. And you can see that in this case, it hasn't been modified. We're looking at the original data. Down below, we got the phase information with the relevant phase fraction. So what we're going to do is we're going to perform a cleanup. And to do that, we go into the data cleanup viewing mode. When we click on that, it goes into this preview mode. And what we see is a data cleanup preview with an inverse pole figure, and the second tab is with a phase map. And we can clearly see where we've got non-index points as marked by the white pixels. On the right-hand side, we've got the cleanup settings. So what we have here, at the top, we have the general settings where we can choose which phases we're applying the cleanup to. By default, it will select all of the phases, but we can toggle these on and off. It will ask if we want to apply the cleanup to the entire data set, or if we've defined subsets, then we can actually apply it to the selected part of the data set. In this case, the selected data set is all of the data because we haven't defined any subsets to start with. We have an auto cleanup button. What this does is run through three processes. It will remove wild spikes, so these are isolated pixels different from all of their neighbors. And then it will go through two stages of zero solution removal. And it will do a six neighbor removal and a five neighbor removal. And I'll come onto those in a little while. We've also got an exclude void checkbox. When I toggle this on, it will allow us to choose a pattern quality parameter, band contrast or band slope. Generally, band slope is working better. And if we have voids or cracks or potentially epoxy at the edge of the sample in this particular map, it will tend to pick those out and protect those from having data falsely grown into that region. In this particular data set, we don't have any voids or cracks or epoxy, so I'm going to leave that switched off. If we apply the wild spikes, then it will go in and it will find isolated pixels different from all of their neighbors and replace them with the most common of the surrounding pixels. So if we go into the map and let's zoom in, for example, we can see a little pixel here which has been indexed with the yellow phase surrounded by the blue phase. Off the top of my head, I can't remember which phase is which. And when I press remove wild spikes, it will go in and it will remove those individual pixels because it will treat them as errors and replace them with one of the neighboring pixels. With the zero solution removal, it works in the same way as channel 5. We have levels of aggression going from the lowest level, which is level 1, up to the highest level, which is level 8. And the levels are dependent on how many of the neighbors have been indexed with the same phase. If we go into a little graphic that kind of highlights this, if we choose, for example, level 4, then we can see that that will need 5 index neighbors, and it will choose one of those index neighbors and copy it into that pixel of interest. If we go to level 7, one of the very aggressive levels, it only needs 2 index neighbors, and it will copy one of those two solutions into the central pixel. So we tend to work from a low aggression through to a high aggression. Very rarely do you need to go to level 7 or level 8. As I said before, the auto cleanup will do a wild spike, and it'll do a level 3 and then a level 4. So if I apply that, you will see it'll run through those two steps. And what it's done here is it's cleaned up those non-indexed pixels along the majority of the grain boundaries. But you can see in some of the phase boundaries, we still have some non-indexed pixels. So we might want to then apply a more aggressive level. So we put that one, and we can see that's cleaned out those non-index points along the grain boundaries and along the phase boundaries. The cleanup steps are listed down below. What we can do if we want to is we can reorder them. So I can, for example, move. I can, let's say I wanted to do a level 2, and I add that in there to the bottom of the list, and then I can move that one up. And what it will do is it will then go through the whole cycle as reordered. I can also delete a step from these recipes. And once again, it'll take that out and it'll repeat the whole process in the order in which we have it. The iteration on the zero solution removal will allow it to continue for as many iterations as we define until there are no more zero solutions that can be removed using that level of aggression. Once we're happy with our cleaning, we can press the apply. If we're not happy, we can simply exit the cleanup stage and we will stick on the original data. So once I've applied it, it will recalculate the maps, it will recalculate the grain size settings and any other calculations and displays that we have created for this particular data set. And you can see down on the left-hand side in the info panel, it tells me that the hit rate is now 99.97%, and it's warning me that this has now been modified. Other ways we can modify the data, for example, is to take a phase, and we could remove a phase from the data set. We can do that by selecting that phase in the phase list, then right mouse clicking and selecting remove phase from data set. Or, for example, we could rename the phase. So if we chose that, potentially we might want to call this austenite. We apply that, and you can see the phase has been renamed. For it to take effect on the active map, we would need to just go out of that map and back into the map, and you can see now the legend is telling me that we have iron BCC and austenite. If I then close down project, so we can close the project by right mouse clicking on the project name and saying close project, and it will prompt me if I want to save it. Now, if I'm using an H5 OINA format dataset, so this new HDFI format, I can save this cleaned dataset and it will not overwrite the original data. If I've opened up a Channel 5 dataset using a CPR, it's really important that we save the clean data with a different name, otherwise we'll overwrite the raw data. But the HDFI, I'm okay to say yes. And it will now store that cleaned dataset as well as the original data. Okay, so I've now got my project down here on the right-hand side. If I open it up again, by clicking on it, it opens up back into AZtecCrystal and it restores exactly where we were before. So you can see the hit rate, 99.97. It's telling me it's modified. It has the phase renamed as austenite. If I want to restore back to the original data, I have two ways I can do that. I can right mouse click on the data set here on the project tree and choose Restore Dataset, or I can go into the Cleanup tab, and now I have this Restore button. And both of those will do the same thing. If I press Restore, it warns me that it's going to undo all changes to the original data, such as the cleanup, deletion or reassignment of phases, and it will take away any subsets that I might have created. So I press OK, and it's now recovering the original data. You'll see goes back to the FCC, it's going back to the original hit rate, saying modified no, and we can see the non-index pixels being restored back into this cleanup viewer. So that's all for this short video. So you can see how we can clean up data, we can store that clean data, and we can restore it back to the original data at a later stage.